Donald Trump inexcusably tells Prince Harry you're on your own after betraying the Queen. The 45th US President, Donald Trump, criticized Prince Harry, calling him unforgivable. Welcome to Royal Pancakes. Please don't forget to subscribe and click the notifications bell, so you don't miss anything about the British royal family. Donald Trump told the Daily Express US that the royal family had been very generous to Prince Harry, and that he would not protect him as Joe Biden did. The former president spoke exclusively to the Express at the CPAC conference in Washington, D.C. as he prepared to wow thousands of conservatives from across America. His comments came 24 hours after Prince Harry appeared in court over whether he lied on his U.S. immigration papers about his drug use, which he admitted in his book Spare. This legal challenge was followed by the Heritage Foundation in Washington, D.C., and the prince fought it off with support from Biden's Department of Homeland Security. The dispute comes amid anger among Republicans over the weaponization of the equality system against Trump. Trump was angry at Joe Biden's administration for protecting Harry by keeping his immigration application secret. He said, "I will not protect him. He betrayed the Queen. This is unforgivable. He'd be alone if it were up to me." He added, "I think they honored him after what he did." The four-day Conservative Political Action Conference in Washington, D.C., this year became an extended rally for Donald Trump, as he was confirmed as the Republican nominee. Speakers, including businessman Vivek Ramaswamy, potential vice presidential nominee Kristi Noem, and close allies including Nigel Farage, stressed the need for a Trump presidency as the West's last hope, before it is too late. Although the convention was quiet compared to previous years, the final day saw huge lines begin early in the morning outside the Gaylord Convention Center to hear the former president's speech. One person said she woke up at 3 a.m. to hear Trump give his State of America speech. Optimism is also high with Trump leading Biden in the polls. Many of the assembled delegates wore a combination of patriotic clothing with Trump hats, Make America Great Again hats, Second Amendment garb in favor of the right to own guns, and stars and stripes attire. Early enthusiasm could be heard through the cheers throughout the line. Allies were making it clear that Trump would come up with a plan to make massive changes within 24 hours of taking office. This includes hundreds of executive orders to undo regulatory reforms introduced by Biden. He also intends to pardon political prisoners who participated in the January 6th insurrection on Capitol Hill.